working as an assistant professor in WIT Solapur. In this video lecture, we are going to learn about the development of the lateral surface of a square pyramid. At the end of this session, students will be able to draw the lateral surface of a regular pyramids like square, pentagonal, hexagonal pyramids. So this is a 3D diagram of a square pyramid. So basically it is a frustum. So here the apex is cut. If you see the first diagram, so here there is no apex. So it is having a base surface as a square, regular square. So and all these corners of the base square are connected at a vertex. So it is called a square pyramid. So it is having four triangular surfaces connecting to vertex to the base edges. So development of this square pyramid, we need to cut this pyramid at one of the inclined edge. So after that, so in the second figure you can see that, so it is cut at this inclined edge. So we can unroll all the surfaces so that we can kept it on development plane. So in the third state it is opening, fourth diagram, fifth diagram, and in the sixth diagram you can see that, so all the triangular surfaces are kept on development plane, and it is of top surface and the bottom surface. So like how we will get all the inclined surface or triangular surfaces kept on development plane, it is called as development of the pyramid. So we see, take one example on square pyramid. The question is that a square pyramid, so which is having base 40 mm and axis height 65 mm, which is rest on HP, and all the edges of the base are equally inclined to VP. It is cut by a sectional plane or cutting plane which is perpendicular to VP, that is vertical plane, inclined at 45 degree to the horizontal plane, and which is bisecting the axis. Draw its sectional top view and true shape of the section. Also draw its development. So for this question, here the square pyramid is resting on HP. So this is the answer for that. So if you see that, so how to draw the development? So this is called the development of that pyramid. To draw this, according to the given condition of the question, here the base surface is resting on HP. So we need to draw one XY line. So this, the XY, the plane which is above the XY line is called as vertical plane, and this plane is the horizontal plane. On the horizontal plane, so according to the given condition, the base surface is resting on HP, horizontal plane. So from the top view, we see that the square surface of the base pyramid, base of the pyramid will be seen with its true shape. So that we need to draw a square in the top view with all of its edges like A, B, BC, CD and AD. All these edges are equally inclined with VP. If these are equally inclined with VP, so from the top view we see that all the edges like AD is 45 degree with XY line, and similarly if this is 45 degree with XY line, on the contrary CD line is also at an angle of 45 degree with VP. So like how, so these two lines are also will be 45 degree with XY line. So this satisfies the condition that, so all the inclined, the edges are equally inclined with VP. Now, so without cutting, this is the apex of the square pyramid which is having its full height, and so this is the front view of the square pyramid. So this is a top view. So this O point is apex point in the top view. Here, this from this point O to this O dash, this is the axis height. So from the top view, we cannot see the height of the axis. So it will be appear as a point in the top view. So here we need to drop O dash point as a point. So it is representing the axis of the pyramid. So from apex point O, we need to collect all the base corners like O to A, O to B, O to C, O to D. These are the inclined edges will be seen from the top view as these apparent lengths. Now we need to draw this with a dark line. So this surface is drawn because this pyramid is cut with this cutting plane, section plane, so which is perpendicular to VP. Since it is perpendicular to VP, so from the front view we cannot see its true shape. We see that section plane as a line, so it is drawn here with a chain line. So now, as per the given condition, so we need to cut this object pyramid, so which is passing at midpoint of the axis height. So this is the midpoint of the axis, so it should pass through this point, and which is inclined with HP by 45 degree. So this the inclination between this line and this line is 45 degree, so we should draw one inclined 45 degree which is passing through the midpoint of the axis, so that represents the cutting plane. So after that we need to remove this part of the pyramid, that is apex side of the pyramid. So this pyramid will remain after cutting or section. So for this pyramid we need to draw the development. Okay, now so from this OA and OC are parallel to VP here, so we need to project these points in the front view so that A will come here. So from A to O we need to connect, so this represents the true length of the inclined edge, that is OA, and OC, it is also true length. OC is also true length of the inclined edge of the pyramid. Now this B and D point to O point, this represents the two inclined edges, that is BO and DO. So from B and D point, since these two comes on same projection, so these two points can be transferred on this XY line. So from this point we can draw the two more inclined edges, but this is not the true length. So this is the true length, OA is a true length. Now without section for the full pyramid we can develop this surface as, so we need to keep O point here first of all, and we need to draw this OA line with a true length. So because here I am taking here OA line because I am cutting this pyramid at OA inclined edge. Since it cut at OA inclined edge, we need to draw this edge with a true length, that is this length. We need to measure with a compass and we need to cut here. And from this point we need to cut one arc approximate length, we need to cut at this radius, OA radius. Now we need to divide this by or we can do that. So A to D we need to measure with a compass, or A to B and BC, CD and AD, all are of equal length since it is a square. So measure any one length and from this A point cut an arc on this circle. So from B to C and mark these points as A, B, C and D and again A, because we need to have four triangular surfaces. Since it is a square means it is having four triangular surfaces, we need to have four true shape of the triangular surfaces. Okay, now name this as A, B, C, D and again A. So this represents the development of the full pyramid without cut. So if it is cut with this given condition, so it is intersecting with this inclined edges at this point. One point is coming on OA inclined edge, and so next is BO inclined edge is here. So the plane is intersecting with this point here, name it as a 2 point. Similarly CO is intersecting here with cutting plane, so this is fourth, and similarly DO is intersecting here. So name this with 1 2 3 4, and we need to, and the next thing is that we need to transfer these heights from apex point or from base on this full development to draw the profile. So I will transfer with O to one distance, so it, since it is on OA, so measure with the compass and from this O point cut an arc on this, so we get here, and one more OA line is here, so cut an arc on this, so we get point number one and point number one. So next is that I will take that third point, so it is on OC, so measure this length with the help of compass and transfer this length on this OC edge. Next thing is that we need to transfer this 2 and 4 point. We cannot directly measure this and we are supposed to transfer on here. It is wrong. We need to do that. We need to transfer this 2 and 4 point first on this true length of the inclined line. Since it is a true length, we need to transfer this length on this true length, that is OA. Now we measure the distance from this point to this point, that is O to this point. So this distance indicates that 2 and 4 at this distance, and we need to measure this and transfer from this point on OB and OD. So this is the correct method. So after this, we need to connect all these 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 point with a straight edge. Since all triangular surfaces are flat, after cutting, we get the profile as straight profile. So after that, so write this development with a dark line. So this surface with a dark line indicates the development of the square pyramid. To draw the true shape of this inclined surface or cut surface from the top view, we can draw the auxiliary top view by seeing from this direction. So for this inclined plane, draw one X1, Y1 line which is parallel to this, and from this you draw the projections and measure the distance of A point from XY line and transfer on this, we get point here. Similarly, from this point B and D point can be transferred here, 2 and 4 point for that. So C point can be transferred here, so this can be transferred here. So we get this shape as a true shape of the inclined cut surface. And you can think that if the direction of the cutting plane, if it is reverse, if the cutting plane, if I take like this, what changes will appear on this development of the surface, whether the profile is same or not? Or if I change the inclination by 45 degree to 30 degree, whether the profile is same or not, that you can think. This is a reference I used. Thank you.